of the United States of America, and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Good morning, Cougars. Today is Wednesday, September 12th. Welcome to SCTV News. I'm Messiah Johnson.
And I'm Cameron Perkins. Today is the third day of Say Something Week. Today, the members of Save Promise Club are talking about what students can do if they've noticed one of the warning signs of potential violence.
I think it's really important that when you notice a sign, a signal, or a threat, to take it seriously and also make sure that you act immediately and go and tell a trusted adult as soon as you can.
A lot of students don't act, one, because they think that they're being a snitch, and what a lot of people don't understand is kind of the definition of a snitch is somebody who's getting somebody else in trouble just for the sole fact of like getting them in trouble. And really, everybody else, and sometimes a lot of the time, students think, oh, somebody else will deal with that, or somebody else saw that, somebody's gonna act on it. But when everybody has that kind of mentality, then nothing gets reported, nothing gets acted on, and then students are really just leaving everything to be, and that's why we have all these problems popping up.
We're gonna have our annual Say Something Week Instagram contest, so make sure that you snap pictures of your Say Something wristbands and messages, and there are gonna be three categories, so that's most creative, most symbolic, and most people. So make sure that you take pictures and relating to those categories. Also, winners will receive an ice cream party, and the winners will be displayed on the broadcast.
Set up your photography game, and don't forget to tag hashtag SCHS_save_promise in your photos to be entered. Only those images displayed publicly will be entered and considered. Posts are due by 3 p.m. tomorrow. Today, join us in the quad for lunch. We'll be making a pledge to say something to a trusted adult. Sign our pledge wall and get your Say Something wristband.
Tomorrow, everyone will be trained in more detail on what it means to say something so that we can make our campus as safe and unified as possible.
Also, don't forget to wear black tomorrow to show your unity for Say Something Week.
You now have the ability to say something on your phone with the Say Something app. Teachers will be training students tomorrow. We will be on a double assembly schedule, but we will not be in the gym. This training takes place in your third block class. Teachers, check your emails for the training information.
We only have two more dress-up days this week. Tomorrow is a blackout, so come dressed in black. Friday, wear green, which is the official color of the Say Something program.
Yesterday, schools across the country remembered the attacks on September 11, 17 years ago. Here on our campus, Mr. Robbins raised two very special flags on our flagpole, each with the victims' names. The top flag was flown at the World Trade Center Memorial and over the Pentagon. The bottom flag was flown over the crash site of Flight 93 in Pennsylvania. Thank you, Mr. Robbins, for helping our campus remember the lives lost on 9/11.
Our school is protected each day by a member of the San Diego Sheriff's Office. You may have seen Deputy Burt around our school, but why is he here, and what does he do? Brendan Johnson, Corrado Lococo, and Andre Rodriguez went looking for answers.
We see this man every day, yet many of us don't even think about why he's here. Deputy Shane Burt is not only a San Diego Sheriff, but he is the protector of our campus. The question is, what exactly does he do?
Well, I've been with the Sheriff's Department now almost 18 years, and this is a position, it's an investigative spot, so you have to interview, and then once you interview, and then they determine on the candidates which one they like best, and they make the selection. So I interviewed for the county position and got picked for this school.
He also has an impact on SCHS students.
I think he keeps us safe, and he provides order to campus, make sure nothing bad happens.
He's a cool guy. I think that he does his job very well. I could never do what he does because I think that it's awesome that he sits there and keeps us safe.
I think having an SRO on campus is a great benefit to students and staff. It adds an extra additional layer of safety and security, and basically another resource for whenever we need additional help from the community.
If you see him on campus, feel free to discuss college football, especially the Boise State Broncos. For SCTV News, I'm Brendan Johnson.
Voting for homecoming court will begin on Friday morning at 9 a.m. The entire student body can vote for 5 boys and 5 girls to be on homecoming court 2018. Voting will be online. We will have details later this week.
Homecoming tickets are $25 with an ASB sticker and $30 without. The price goes up again later this month. If you're bringing a guest from another school, they need to have a guest pass. You'll find them on the school website.
Every Wednesday, SCTV News is partnering with the special education teachers and students in room D110 for a weekly weather report. Here's what to expect for the rest of the week.
Good Wednesday. Morning. Good girls. All right. Sin. Here. It's a cool part. Low. 80s. And. Getting. And in the week, your weather to back to the news.
This Friday, celebrate the end of the week with a trip to Rubio's. The restaurant will donate a portion of sales to the Steel Regiment. Just bring in the flyer from the Steel Regiment's social media accounts to take part in the fundraiser.
Your keys, flash drives, and other items would look great on Steel Canyon lanyards. You can pick one up for just $10 in room K110. Sales go to the room of class of 2020.
Girls tennis plays against Granite Hills here at 4.
Girls volleyball plays at Mount Carmel. Freshman and JV at 4, varsity at 5:30.
That's all the news we have for you today. Don't forget to dress for the blackout tomorrow. Rah, rah, Cougars.
Cougar pride.
Get some.